Hi, my name is Carly McAvoy. I'm working on fractions today, looking at mixed numbers. Mixed numbers just means that you have a whole number part and a fraction part together. So these first four examples all have mixed numbers throughout them. Let's move our little icon here. Okay, so in the first one, though, it says estimate the answer by rounding. So I don't want you to do to put this into your calculator or work it out on paper. I want you to round this, round that, and then see what you think the estimated answer is. Because in life, we do more estimating than actual calculating. So I want you to focus on what would this be about. So what I'm always wanting you to think of is the fractional part. And the fractional part is either less than a half or more than one half. If it's less than one half, it goes back to 5. If it's half or more, it goes up to 6. Well, 1/6, okay, half of 6 is 3. 1/6 is actually less than half. So this would become approximately 5. What about 5/7? Well, what's half of 7? It's 3.5. We have more than 3.5, so we're more than half. We're going to take the 3 up to 4. So the answer, the estimated answer is 20. Sometimes when people estimate things, approximate things, you'll see the wavy lines, approximately 20. That's a nice estimate. What would it be if we actually calculated that problem? Well, let's put that into the calculator and see what we get. I'm going to use the second function in 7 button. This little thing right here, you can see it looks like a mixed number. I'm going to go ahead and do that on the calculator. 5, I use the arrow button to arrow over or arrow down to move around. Times, I'm going to use that button again, second function, number 7, and then 3 5/7. Now this is the exact answer. I don't really care what's 403 divided by 21. 19.19. So we said it was approximately 20. Yeah, it looks like approximately 20. So that's an approximation. I don't care about the actual number there. Okay, so 4/5. Well, half of 5 is 2.5, and we have more than half, so this is bigger than half, so we're going to round that up to 2. Half of 8 is 4. 1/8 is less than 4, then less than half, and so we're going to go down to 3, and 2 plus 3 is about 5. That's my approximation. You should try these other two without watching me, and then come back and see how you do. Pause it, come back. Okay, on this one, half of 9 would be 4.5. We have more than 4.5, so we're going to go up to 10. And half of 6 would be 3. We have more than half, so we're going to go up to 2. And 10 divided by 2 is approximately 5. 6.5, well, if you have exactly a half, you go up. So that's 7. And then half of 5 is 2.5, but we have less than 2.5, so we're going to go down to 2, and 7 minus 2 is approximately 5. I did not mean to make those answers all come out to 5, but I just made them up, and that's how it turned out. That's estimating first. Okay, let's multiply and divide actual mixed numbers and see how you do that. I'm going to move this up just a little. We'll leave our estimates in there for now. 4 1/5 times 5/9. When you want to multiply and divide fractions and you're not using a calculator, you want to change this into an improper fraction. That is 4 times 5 is 20 plus 1 makes 21. And then I have 5/9. So what I'm going to do when I multiply this is I'm going to cancel because 5s go into each self once. And then 3 goes into 21 and 9. 3 goes into 9 3 times, into 21 7 times, and I get 7 times 1, 1 times 3. Now, when you're entering an answer on a test, for me or for most instructors, they're going to be either fine with an improper fraction or they'll say, give your answer in mixed number form. So you have to ask, you know, what they want or know what they want. 3 goes into 7 twice with 1 left over. And whichever answer you're asked for. On Math Excel, which we use in our class, they typically like the improper fraction answer, and if they don't want that, they'll say give an integer or mixed number answer. So they ask you specifically for mixed number. Okay, what about this one? Well, whenever you have a division problem, you want to flip and multiply, but don't flip until you've turned it into an improper fraction. How do I turn 7 into an improper fraction? Well, I just put a 1 under it. And then I have 1 times 5 is 5, plus 3 is 8. And now I'm ready to do the process, which is change the division to multiplication and flip that next term. And then I can cross-cancel, but there's nothing to cross-cancel. So I'm going to multiply across and get 35 over 8. And if somebody wanted you to put that as a mixed number, you'd say 8 goes into 35 4 times. 4 times 8 is 32, so there's 3 left over, and that's that. You can change back and forth between an improper. I use different calculators. I'm trying to, you know, I don't know which calculator you have. But let's see. This button up here above the fraction button changes things from mixed numbers to improper. So let's do that last problem. 7 divided by, when you do 1 and 3 fifths on this calculator, you do 1, hit the fraction button, 3, hit the fraction button, 5. And that tells it it's 1 and 3 fifths. You hit the fraction button between each number. And then hit enter, and it's going to give you the mixed number. 4 3/8. But let's say your computer or your teacher wants you to give the answer as an improper fraction. Go back, leave that answer in there, and hit second function and this button. And this says it's going to change your mixed number into an improper, and hit enter. And that will give you the 35/8. That's this button for fractions, but second function this button to change your fractions back and forth. If I decide now I want to take that back to a mixed number, then I'd go second function, hit that button again, and it would turn it back. It's going to toggle back and forth between those two. Okay. Subtract and add mixed numbers. So when you add and subtract a mixed number, you need to find a common denominator just like you did with other numbers. And so the common denominator here is 25 for this particular problem. Now notice that the bottom already had 25, so I wouldn't change that. And the top, I need to multiply 5 times 5 to get 25, so 1 times 5 to get 5. And then you add the mixed number part, you add the fraction part, excuse me, and the whole number part. 5 and 2 is 7, and 9 and 8 is 17. And there's your answer, 17 and 7/25, and you could change that into an improper if you needed to, by using the calculator function that I just showed you. Okay, and I think, I don't know on the T, let's see if I can figure it out on the TI-36X Pro. If I hit this button, second function 7, it takes me to that improper fraction button. And if I do 17 and then 7/25, and hit enter. Yeah, so if I just enter that and then hit enter, it turns it into the improper fraction. So that's easy to do as well. Okay, now I'm going to subtract, and I'm going to find a common denominator. That's going to be 4. This already has a 4, so that doesn't change. 2 times 2 is 4. 1 times 2 is 2. And now I'm ready to subtract. 3 minus 2 is 1/4, and 5 minus 2 is 3. So that would be subtracting with mixed numbers. The last two I want to show you have to do with subtracting again, but also they have to do with borrowing, which makes them a little more difficult for people. So I don't know why I picked these big numbers that I can't even do in my head, but anyways, we'll do that on the calculator. So the common denominator for 15 and 10, well, not just the common, but the least common. So they both go into 30. So that's what I want to do, is change those into 30. I was able to do that in my head. You can count by 15s. We did that before in a different video. So 15 times 2 is 30. So 2 times 2 is 4. And 10 times 3 is 30. So 3 times 3 is 9. I'm getting quite a glare off something here. I don't know why. Hopefully you can see that. And then It says take 9 away from 4, but you can't do that, right? You can't take 9 away from 4 so without getting a negative number. So you have to come over here, to come over here and borrow from your 86 and make that 85. And then you borrowed, you're talking about 30ths. So that one that you borrowed is actually 30 30ths. So you already had 4 and you just borrowed 30 more. That becomes 34 30ths. Okay. And that's tricky, the tricky borrowing piece. So if you're having trouble with that, use your calculator. The other method is to change them both into improper fractions and then work with them that way. I prefer the borrowing method. If you want to find a different method, you know, there's a zillion videos out there on YouTube. Go find a method that works for you. 34 minus 9 is 25. And then 85 minus 27. Off camera, doing subtraction is 58. Okay, and then I can't leave this answer because this is not simplified. I can divide the top and the bottom here by 5 and reduce that fraction. So reducing or simplifying means making sure there's no common factors between the numerator and denominator. So I have 58, and then I have 5/6. And again, you could do that problem readily on your calculator. That's a kind of a problem that if you had that, no one's expecting you to do that in your head on the job. So go ahead and learn how to do it on a calculator and then have your calculator ready if you need it. Okay, so this one, 7 and minus 1 and 3/5. Well, you know, you can't take 3/5 away from nothing. So we need to rewrite the 7 as 6 and 5/5. 5/5 is equal to 1 plus the 6 makes 7. And so now I can subtract that. 3 from 5 is 2, and 6 from 1 is 5. Fractions are intimidating. If you're having trouble with fractions, get to know how to do fractions on your calculator. All right, have a fantastic day, and I will see you next time.